yes, 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 yes. Yes, 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 yes.
I never made it out that window.
Top. that fire right. Come down, drop those bones, drop.
The buzz is going to the monkey, oh, choking me. Release your whole house and the monkey looked at buzz right dead in the eyes.
The story's touchy, but it sounds like a lie.
Straighten up that fire right. Straighten up that fire right. Straighten up and do right. Straighten up and stay right. Straighten up and fly right. Cook down, Papa, don't you blow. No, and all.
Thank you.
when the storm clouds are gathered and the lightning's bright. And don't
You'll probably be the dead man. I said, yes, and amen. And I will stand tall, and I will stand tall until I meet my end.
Yeah. Hey! on fiddle from Northport, Washington, Luke Bullock. Playing guitar and mandolin from North Manchester, Indiana, Jeff White. On steel guitar from Nashville, Buck Reed. On guitar from Los Angeles, James Hera. On bass from Los Angeles, the one and only Leland Sklar. On drums from Los Angeles, the one and only Russ Kunkel. We are thrilled to all be together. The last time we got to play a tour, got to do a tour as a large band, was in 2019. And we got to play right here at the Chateau Sunday Show. We appreciate the way you folks have supported us all these years. We appreciate that you're willing to sit close to one another. Well, it's been weird, hasn't it? It's still weird. All of us have done different things, did different things during the isolation to try to keep going. And to all of you who supported our live streams, we thank you. You made a difference in our lives. We missed playing in person, but we were just grateful to play at all, and we thank you. I look at it, it's so nice to play when it's still daylight because you folks are the show for us. I mean, I can see my friends. I have actual friends in the world who know me and they come to my shows anyway. And That's a true friend. Dallas, Madelon, Stacy, thank you for being here. Leroy and Beth Leshford. Leroy, came down from Anchorage, Alaska for the show. I know Leroy and Beth from my days at Texas A&M. We all worked on the school newspaper together, and Leroy is proudly wearing. Leroy, you are a fine egg. I met my friend Robert O'Keen at Texas A&M in 1976. We became fast friends. We were the two students in the College of Liberal Arts at Texas A&M in 1976. Robert was an English major and I was a journalism major, and so we both liked words and sentences and paragraphs. Sort of brought us together. But we were both, pretty consumed with wanting to try to play and sing in those days, and sometimes our schoolwork suffered as a result. But we loved being in school. We loved being in school so much that Robert was class of 78, and I was class of 79. We both graduated on the same day in August of 1980. That's how much we loved Texas A&M. As the spring of 1980 rolled around, we knew it was inevitable they were going to graduate us, whether we wanted them to or not. And we knew that we were going to miss people and places that were familiar to us, and we were going to miss each other because we knew our lives would change. We knew that we wanted to play music. We weren't sure that it was a realistic aspiration because Robert and I both come from Houston, and, making stuff up and peddling it around the country is not thought of as a real job. Ro- Robert played me a song in the spring of 1980. We used to do that for each other. We'd play it, we'd just make something up, and we'd play it. I was often the first person to get to hear one of Robert's songs, and vice versa. And he played me a song that I loved so much, I said, okay, I'm not leaving until you teach it to me. So he did, and I went back to my little apartment around the corner and played it and played it and played it. And I started thinking about the places Robert described. They were all places that we went to regularly and that we loved. And I started thinking about Robert himself and the unique relationship he had with his landlord, a man named Jack Boyette, who was viewed by most of his tenants as a true eccentric. He had a habit of, and really innocently, just checking on houses that he'd rent to students. But he would just walk in just to check on it. He surprised a lot of his tenants that way. And he was not overly popular. I knew him by reputation when I first met him at Robert's house. And he pulled up to Robert's house one day, and he just kind of glided his pickup truck. He turned off the ignition and put it in neutral and just coasted to a stop right perfectly in front of Robert's walkway. He walked right up the center walkway, up the steps, right into the house. And I thought, uh-oh, what's going to happen? And Robert Keene said, hey, Mr. Boyette, come on in. Like that. I always admired Robert's kindness to Mr. Boyette, even as Mr. Boyette would walk through the house and open the refrigerator to see what was in there. It was because of Robert's kindness to Mr. Boyette I had a chance to know him and to appreciate what a kind man he was himself. As I played Robert's song, I thought to myself, you know, Robert wrote about these wonderful places that we went to, but he left himself out of the song. And so I, without Robert's knowledge or permission, started making up my own verses to Robert's song. And when I finished, I went over to Robert's house and said, okay, just hear me out. And much to my delight, from that day forward, Robert Keene played his song with my verses included in it, and has ever since. And so that's how we came to make this song up together. It's for Leroy and Beth.
Big old red. red-haired 70 years is doing all it can not to give in to the city. And he always takes the red day, so long as I run his cattle. And he picks me up at dinner time, and I listen to him rattle. He says the grass still runs muddy, just like she's run all along. And there ain't never been no game to grind. The cotton's all but gone, and you know this brand new Chevrolet, and hell, it was something back in '60. Now they want nobody to listen to, cause they all think he's crazy. And this authority took a long time of waiting and forgetting and remembering the coming back, and not crying about the leaving, and remembering the falling down and the laughter of love from all of those passersby who said we'd never get back up. Yet this old gorge is just a long time of waiting and and remembering the coming back, and not crying about the leaving, and remembering the falling down and the laughter of the curse of love from all of those that signs and bitches who said we'd never get back up.
Blake Neely is here. Blake is from deep East Texas, Paris, Texas, and my family's from East Texas, San Jacinto County, a lot farther down south, closer to Houston. That's where the Lovetts moved to from Georgia in 1850. We have a family cemetery there with graves that go back, you know, almost that far. Kind of keeps the family together, really, the extended family. On both sides of the ground, we have lots of family cemetery business. It gives us a reason to associate, really, and it's a beautiful spot. When my dad's generation was responsible for taking care of the cemetery, we'd go up there. I was a little boy. We'd go up there every 2 or 3 weeks to mow and trim, make sure it was always presentable. And I had lots of cousins to play with, and we could go out in the woods and just get lost all morning while our dads worked. And our moms would always cook something, bring a covered dish, and we'd have a picnic when the work was done, right there under the pine trees, right there at the cemetery. It was a joyful place. It was never a sad or morbid place. And now that my generation is in charge of caring for the cemetery, we hire out the mowing, but we get together and once a year, and we reenact that picnic lunch under the pine trees, and now I get to watch my children play with their cousins out in those woods and the little creek that runs by the cemetery.
Before spring turned into summer, after night turned into day. They were born a Monday morning in the days just after May. In the days just after May. By the bridge, it's Jason. Play for me a happy tune. Know of all the days I love best the 12th of June. I love best the 12th of June. one and said, give me something. I kiss my ass, I fall it, oh, I'm going out to see.
Joel's horns, Steve Herman. On tenor from Atlanta, Georgia, originally from Waco, Texas, Mace Hibbard.
Yeah.
On alto from Denton, Texas, and the University of North Texas, where he is professor of saxophone. This is his summer job, ladies and gentlemen. The professor, Brad Lely. Singing with us from Los Angeles, Willie Green, Jr. You met him already. From Oakland, Lamont Van Hook. You met him already from Oakland, Lamont Van Hook. You met him already from Oakland, Lamont Van Hook. And from Nashville, Jason Eskridge. So far in his young life, my son is a vegetarian, except he loves bacon.
I'm not lying.
So
feet as we were driving down the highway. She asked me, baby, what's so great? How come you're always going on about your own stuff? I said, that's right, you're not an exist. That's right, you're not an exist. That's right, you're not an exist. That's right, you won't be anywhere. That's right. You're not Texas, that's right, you're not Texas, that's right, you're not Texas, Texas wants you to be great on the road. It looks so lovely, she stood there on the side, and she grew smaller in my mirror as I watched her.
Texas wants you anyway.